Hey there, this is Prashant. So, PUBG Mobile released a new event yesterday. And so, today's video, we are going to talk about everything you need to know about the Ancient Secret event. This event starts from the 14th of August until the 13th of August. And the special event takes place in two maps, which is Wrangle and also Miramar. You have the option to turn off and on the event. So that's, I guess, a plus one in case you don't want to join the event or for some reason, I don't know. I'm not judging. On the spawn island or spawn area, depending on where you are on Erango or Miramar, you'll be greeted by this huge Pharaoh illusion thing where it is quite amazing visually, to be honest. Kudos to the project team for that. And also, there at the spawn area, there will be a few sarcophagus, which if you were playing the event mode or you turn on the event before you join the game, you can enter the sarcophagus and you can obtain this thing called the Pharaoh Script, which we will be going into that later on. Opening the map, there will be multiple yellow markings, with the big ones being the main temple, and also the smaller ones are, I would call them tiny tombs, I guess. So let's just talk about the temples first, the big main temples. If you look at the bottom part of the map, there will be another additional timer which is specific for the main temples. From the plane, the timer will start around 5 minutes and 40 seconds, I guess, which after the timer ends, it will cause the temples to rise up into the air. The loot in the temple, that is what people would be asking about. To me, it would be quite okay, probably more than enough if you're playing solos or duos, but it would just be just enough for a full squad. You won't be able to collect loot to go on a ramp on a killing spree, but if you go as a squad, you go there, the loot will be just enough. Dropping into the temple, considering you survived the hard drop, you will find 4 puzzles or 4 puzzle chambers, which is located on 4 corners of the temples, which consists of memory puzzles, the light up puzzles, which I hate, rotating puzzles, and also a quiz, simple quiz, to be honest. So solving these puzzles would open up a chest in that particular loot, which actually gives you some nice loot. And opening the chest also curses you, basically turning you into a mummy for a short period of time. It will wear off soon. It doesn't affect the gameplay, so don't worry about it. After the temple has risen into the air, and after you have solved all 4 puzzles, and considering you survive the hot drop, you should go to the upper floor of the temple and you can enter the Pharaoh's room, which when you go in there, you should just collect all the loot from there first. Then you need to go and activate the 2 statues at the corner of the room. Doing this will close the room door, and also it will activate some boss fight. So basically all you have to do is to just shoot down the boss, the guardian as the game calls it, and also there are also snakes in the room, so killing the snakes will give you ammo, but try to stay away from them because they can attack you, and the guardians can also gives off some attacks, but to be honest it's not that painful, but you still need to dodge the attacks. So after dodging the snakes, dodging the attacks from the guardians, and finishing off the guardian, you will be rewarded with the guardian's chest, which will give you some epic loot. So far I've played a few rounds and I only get some AWM, the AWM, and also ghillie suit, and also an 8x scope. But to be honest, like from this footage I played with my friends, the crate also gave out Rosa, but from my experiences of playing this match in solos and also 2 times in squads, the arm combo would be the most common. Now that you're done with the boss fight, you floated. It's either you jump off the temple, or you can just sit there on the temple as it floats around. One thing that I can tell you is that the temple will always be in the safe zone. So if you decide to stay on the temple, it would provide a good strategy, I guess. Oh, and also you can also shoot people while you're on the temple if you have extremely good aim. The temple will stay in the air for around 10 minutes, starting from when it started to rise. And after the temple ends, the temple will disappear and you will be dropped down to the ground. But don't worry, whether you decided to jump off or you drop off from the disappearing temple, you will have a parachute on, so you won't plummet to your death. Don't worry about it. So when you just drop off, you can continue your hunt for that elusive chicken dinner. Okay, tiny tombs. So from there you can see these spike thingies where it's actually this tiny tombs. They are scattered all over the map randomly, similar to the temple. They are very similar to the puzzle rooms in the temples. So the same gimmick, solve the puzzles and get loot from the chest and also get cursed. That's all. And as you walk around, as you explore the map, you will encounter this golden chair thing, which is the Pharaoh's throne. I found this one in Rosshawk. I'm not really sure whether it has a fixed spawn position or it's randomly spawning. I haven't checked on that yet because this picture was the first time I found the chair. So interact with it and you will get the Pharaoh's key, which when you will be used along with the Pharaoh's crate mentioned from the sarcophagus situation. You will use them to in the Call of the Pharaohs event to get some nice loot. To be honest, there's some items with timers, some coins. There's also the character coupons if you're interested in that. Not only that, there is also the Pharaoh Rises lucky spin, which you will get a chance to get the Golden Pharaoh X suit, which is so epic. So that's all you need to know from the event, I guess ish. So hit that like button somewhere down there if this video helps you understand more about the event. Leave any questions or something I miss for the event in the comment below. I will try to answer them. And don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss out any new contents I made, whether it's about your random crap I made. So I guess that's it for this video. I'll catch you in my other videos. Or I'll be blowing off your head using an orb. Who knows?